In SOLIDWORKS Simulation, we have first and second order elements, also known as high and rough quality. To ensure accurate results, we recommend to use high quality. So what is the use of rough quality now? Well, it can be used on components that are not of interest, or to speed up the calculation and get quick and dirty results. My most common use of drop quality elements, and what I will demonstrate in this video, is using it to verify the setup of a simulation. In this case, I have already created a study with the fixture at the bottom and a pressure load on all internal faces. Next step here would be to mesh and run it. But first, I will create a copy where I use rough quality elements to verify the setup. To apply rough quality to all, I can right-click the parts folder and select apply rough quality to all. Then I'll go into my mesh and set it to default. I could also change between high and rough quality here. From the mesh box, I can also check the box to have it run directly after creating the mesh. As you can see, this completes fairly quickly and the setup seems right, but we can also see that the quality of the results is not good enough. So I go back to my high quality study. Here I have created the mesh with a maximum element size of 5 to ensure two elements across the smallest thickness, which is 10 millimeters. You should always have a minimum of 2 elements across the thickness when using high quality solid elements to obtain high quality and reliable results. I have already run this study, and if I look at the stress plots, I can see that my results look much better than what it did with the draft quality mesh. And if I right click and select solve a message, I can also see that the simulation took approximately 30 minutes, which is quite a lot more than what we saw with draft quality, even for such a small part as this.